Hello friends. Okay, so this time around we just want to continue from where we ended in the first video on binomial expansions. Okay, so a brief overview or introduction was made in the first video. Okay, so I think just to a bit of recap on what we did is we said this binomial expansion basically is about the expansion of a given expression. Okay, expansion of a given expression. Take for example, we are told to expand this kind of expression. Okay, so when we expand this, this is an expression. When we expand it, that is what is making the binomial expansion. And then again, we said if it is to the power 3, okay, like in this case, if it is to the power 3, then the number of terms you are expecting will be 4. Okay, then if it is to the power 10, you expect 11, just like that. And then what usually happens from the work that I gave you was there was where they said in ascending or in descending. You don't have to worry on that, okay? The expression itself, when you expand, it will tell you the way the variables are being arranged. Okay, so for example, if they say you expand, then the values of x will be ascending. Then they are saying they will be gaining the power, that is ascending. Okay, so maybe the first term of x plus the second term of x squared plus the third term of x to the power 3. So this is it, ascending. Okay, it is ascending. So when they say descending, you just have to expand, then itself it will show you that it is descending, meaning opposite to that. Okay, so basically that is in the overview of what we did, and I'm sure you picked the concept on those examples in the first video. So now this time around we want to move on with other examples based on the same expansion, okay, or binomial expansion. This question was shown that 10 choose 3 is equal to 10 choose 7. We want to show if these two are the same, okay, under binomial expansion. Now what really are we talking about here? When you find it written in this way, 10 choose 3, or others still say 10 combination 3, okay, this means in other books or in other examples you find it written like this. Okay, you find it written like that. Okay, especially on the calculator, there is a C on the scientific calculator. C, that is for combination. Okay, then the other one is a P for permutation, but we'll come back to that some other time. So this time we just want to look at this 10 choose 3. If you go direct on the calculator, it will give you the answer. Okay, it will give you the answer there. Boom. And then now you here they are saying this will be the same as this. They want us to show why this is, these two are the same. Okay, I will be a bit slow because the madam said we are too fast. Okay, so now we want to show that this is equal to this. Even when I say 20 choose 5, okay, you will agree with me that this will be the same as 20 choose 15. Now why is it like this? Why is it like this? Why we are getting this is, if I say 20 choose 3, if I want to find the other one that will be equal, I will subtract 20, take away 5. Okay, 20 take away 5, that will give me 15. So meaning, this will be the same as 20 choose 15. So this is probably correct. Now, how do we show that these two are the same? Given in the question, the exam. So now, we translate this from the binomial expansion or from the binomial theorem. Okay, from the binomial theorem, because the formula there was A plus B, the power N is equal to AN plus M1, AN minus 1, B plus N minus 2, AN minus 2, B squared, just like that. You need to know this formula, okay? You need to know this formula, at least it must be here. Then from this, as it goes on there, there will see now this formation to the NR, then AN minus R, BR. Okay, so now this I said in the first video, this is very, very important. This is for combination. Okay, it's like you've got certain number of objects. Okay, let's say 10 objects here. Yeah. Then you are taught to pick three objects at a time. In how many ways? Okay, those are the questions. In how many ways can this be done? You've got 10 objects and then you are told to pick three at a time. Okay, so in how many ways can you do that? So that's the answer we are answering. This is the kind of combination we are talking about. So we'll still come back to this in the next example, why we apply this. Remember I said this mainly is important where they ask you to find the term which is independent of who? X or any variable given. Okay, so in the examples that I've given you, there is a question based on this. Finding the term independent of X, what and what. So this is the one that is very much applicable that. So to show that this is equal to this, what we usually do is we express this in another form. That is the simplest way. So 10 choosing 3 means 10 factorial, okay? So now we are interpreting this. Means 10 factorial over 10 minus this 3 here, factorial, then 3 factorial. So this means this. So in another way, for the combination, the formula for the combination is n factorial over n minus r factorial r factorial. This is the meaning. And this is the formula for combination. This is the formula for combination. And then when we come to permutation, permutation will be using n factorial over n minus r factorial. For combination, it ends there. Okay, so for permutation, and for permutation is n there, then for combination, this is the formula. So when you say 10 choose 3, this is what I mean here. So 10 choose 3, I'll say the 10 is n, the 3 is r, then you substitute. Okay, this is what exactly what I've done. Then from here, we now also want to express on the other side how it will be. So on the other side, it will be equal to this, will be 10 factorial over 10 minus 7, you put them in brackets, factorial, then 7 factorial. Okay, so the answer that we are supposed to find here will be the same, should be the same on the other side. Then we have proven that these two are equal. Okay. So 10 factorial, let's subtract first here. So on top we are going to have 10 factorial over 10 take away 3, that gives us 7 factorial, then we have 3 factorial. And then equals 10 factorial, that is 10 factorial, 10 take away 7, that is 3 factorial, 7 factorial. Maybe in case you don't understand the meaning of this factorial, I'm talking about factorial. When you say five factorial, there is this symbol factorial on the calculator, scientific calculator. The meaning of this is when you say five factorial, this is the same as 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So the answer you get here, that's the same. That's the meaning of that. So getting back to this, when you say 10 factorial there, then I'll say 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 factorial. So why have I put the 7 factorial here? Because I've seen that under here there's a 7 factorial. So there's no need for me to go and finish it up like that. If you want, you can finish it. There is no problem with that. Okay, but we just want to shorten some steps there. Okay, for easy understanding. So you can go on up to 1, then over the 7 factorial. I'm not going to expand 7 factorial because I want them to come and cancel. Okay, so 7 factorial, I'll just say 7 factorial, just like that. Then 3 factorial, I can now expand 3 factorial, which will be 3 times 2 times 1. Okay, then on the other side, 10 factorial will be 10 multiplied by
9 multiplied by 8, then multiplied by 7 factorial again, because I've seen 7 factorial there. Then over down part to be 3 times 2 times 1 times it, 7 factorial. Okay, then I can cancel. Okay, I can cancel those that can be cancelled. So 7 factorial, I'll cancel like that. Okay, then what else can I reduce here? A 2 and a 10, okay? Or a 2 and a 8 here. I'll say 2 in there, 1. 2 in 8, 4. A 3 and a 9 as well. So a 3 in there, 1, 3 in there, 3, okay? And then on the other side, I will cancel the 7 factorial and the 7 factorial there, as well as the 3 and the 9, 3 there, 1, 3 here, wavu, 3, and then 2 and 8, 2 there, 1, 2 there, 4, and then I will multiply the remaining, okay, so I'll multiply the remaining, so I've got 10 times 3 times 4, and this gives us 12 times 10, that is 120. Okay, so that will give me 120 this side. Is equal to, here to be 10 times 3 times 4, which will be 120. So you can see now that we have shown. So at the end of it all, you say now, hence shown. Hence shown. That is the way we prove this. Okay, so now let's look at it. This was example number 1. Let's look at the next example. Okay, so let's look at the next example, example 2 there. Now this example says find the 5th and the 6th terms in the expansion of 2x minus 1 over 2 to the power 10. Okay, so in that question, you are not asked to expand. They just want specific terms. Okay, they just want specific terms in the expansion. So there's no need for you to start expanding all this to the power 10, all of it, then you get it. To shorten up the process there, there's just a formula that we use here, okay? It's just a formula that you can use so that you avoid that way of expanding everything. Well and good, you can, if you forget the formula, that is another alternative. You can expand, then you get the term which is number 6, number 5, and you also get the term number 6. Those are the answers they want, okay, in that expansion. Now, the formula which we usually use here is the one that I actually alluded to earlier. And so our solution there will be, the formula that we are supposed to use is n r, n minus r, b r. Okay? So this is the formula which is used for the independent of a term together with this kind of questions when you just want the specific term without expanding everything. So you use this one. N choose R, N minus R, B, R. Okay, so you just have to know this simple formula here. Now what's the application of this formula here? Okay, what is R, N, A, and B? So in here, the expansion we have is 2, let me write the expansion here, 2x minus 1 over 2, the power 10. Okay, so in this expansion, we have to collect the data so that we know the right figures to put in these variables. Your A is the first term here, okay? So your A will be our 2x there, that is our A. Then B is the second term. Okay, so in this case, B is negative 1 over 2. So please don't forget, if it's negative, it's minus here, you also need to indicate there, okay? Unless if it is positive. So this is our A, this is our B there. And then our M is the power. Again, our M is the power. So this is to the power 10. Then what is remaining here is R. Okay, so on R, this is now where you get it. Me very well. If you are looking for the 5th term, term number 5, then your R is 4. You reduce by 1, you subtract 1. Okay, so if you are looking for term number 5, your R is 4. If you're looking for them number 6, your R will be 5. If you're looking for them number 11, your R will be 10. So that's the way to go. That's how you'll be finding R. So after this delta here, now you can just put in the formula and then try to solve and see what we get. So if we substitute in the formula here, our M is 10, so it's 10. Our R is 4, so it will be 10. Choose 4. Then our A is 2x. 2x there. When substituting, you have to be putting in brackets. Then the N is 10 minus 4. Then B is negative 1 over 2 to the power 4. Okay, then we try to solve this and see what we'll get at the end of it all. Okay, so now the calculations here are, if you have 10, choose 4. So using the calculator there, you get 210. Okay, you get 210 for 10 choose 4. So you can just punch in on your scientific calculator, 10 choose 4. It will give you 210 there. Okay, then we have 2x here, 10 take away 4, that gives us 6, okay, and then on the other side, since the power here is an even number, so meaning the negative will cancel, the negative will turn into a positive because we've got an even number here, because negative 1 over 2 to the power 4. This is the same as having negative 1 over 2 times negative 1 over 2 times negative 1 over 2 times negative 1 over 2. So there are 4 of them. So since there are 4, this will give us a positive. Okay. And then this will be a positive 1 over, when I multiply the denominators, I'll get 16. So here, everything there, I'll get 1 over 16. Okay, and then you cannot multiply 210 and 2 to say 210 times 2. No, you cannot do that. Why? Because 2x has a power on top here. It has a power. So get rid of the power. After you get rid of the power, that's when you come and multiply with this and also the other side. Okay, so now we have 210 here, then 2 to the power 6, this will give us 64. So if you use the calculator there, this will give us 64. Then there is x here, which is raised to power 6, like that. Then multiply by 1 over 16. So now here, now you can multiply, since now there is no power which is raised here. So you can multiply to find the correct answer using the calculator here. 210 times 64 times 1 over 16. The combined answer that you are supposed to get is 840x to the power 6. So if you expand this, expansion, you'll find that the term that will be on position number 5, the fifth term, will be 840x to the power 6. So this is the term that they wanted. Okay, so I'll leave it here in this video. Then try to get the answer to that. What will be the sixth term? And give me the answer at the end of it. Okay, thank you.